Hi, I'm Nick Heidfeld, driving in the Formula E Championship for Mahindra Racing. Today we are looking at driver safety. Welcome to Race School. In Formula E, we usually drive on street circuits, which actually makes it a little bit more dangerous because there's little room for error. Normally there are no runoff areas, it's just a concrete wall. Safety obviously is important to us drivers and luckily also to the teams and especially the FIA, who have pushed massively over the last couple of years. We have a protection for side impact, so this not only looks cool, but actually it's important for safety. Inside here we have a crash structure that helps in case of a side impact. The side walls here that have come a lot higher compared to the past. If you look at racing maybe 10, 15 years ago, the side walls were a lot lower, and that meant in case of a side impact you had a lot higher chances of having a bad injury. Similar to a road car, we have seat belts, but they are fixed at 6 points, 2 from the top, 2 from the sides, and 2 come in from the front. And then of course we have the seat, which also helps in case of a crash, because it's really did to your shape, to your body shape, so you will move around a lot less, which helps for quick driving because you just keep in position. Another important thing that was introduced over the last couple of years is the fact that the seat can be taken out together with the driver. In case you have a really nasty accident and the doctors think you might have damaged something or broken something, they have an extraction team that is practicing a lot how to take you out without damaging anything. Also inside the cockpit we have the headrest, which is here, and the leg protection in front, and it's made out of a special material which seems to be quite soft if you push it slowly, but in case of a quick impact it really takes a lot of energy. On a normal race car with a normal combustion engine, through here we get some air for the engine and more power. In Formula E with an electric engine, battery is not necessary, but this is very important because it's a roll hoop. So if you roll the car, and if you take a line from here to this point at the front, your helmet and head should always be well below. So in case if you roll the car, that you are safe. So there are a lot of things protecting us in terms, in case of a crash, but unfortunately it can happen from time to time. And usually if it's a bigger one and you see the wall coming towards you a bit too quick, what you naturally do and should do is take the hands off the steering wheel, because if you touch the wall with the wheels first, it might be that the wheel turns around very quickly and can actually break something on your hand. So normally you take off your hands, put them in front of your chest, and also naturally you start to tense your muscle, again to just protect your body. In many places where we can go off, there's barriers made with tires, but actually nowadays we have TechPro, which is designed to absorb the energy a lot better. So in most places where we arrive with high speed, and there's a high chance for an accident, we will have a TechPro barrier. So in case you have an off or even a small crash, you have to decide yourself if it's still safe to continue to bring the car home and have it repaired, or if it's better to just stop. Sometimes it's obvious that you cannot continue, and then you try to get out of the car in the safest way possible. Obviously, it's quite safe in there, so sometimes it's better to have a look around if there's a lot of cars approaching, wait a few seconds and then get out quickly. By regulation, you have to put the steering wheel back on so that the marshals can move the car. Again, if there's no wheels left on the car, it's pointless to do that. A unique thing for Formula E and electric racing is 3 lights in front. Hopefully they will always be green. If it's red, it means the car is live. And if you go out of the car, actually you have to try and not touch the car and the floor at the same time. And if this shows a green light, that means the car is safe and you can easily and safely go out. This sounds very easy in theory, but for example, the big crash I had in race 1 in Beijing when I was upside down, I just realized afterwards that I didn't check, so I just moved out. But luckily the cars and especially the battery and the casing is built in a very safe and strong way, so everything was fine. We have some G sensors in the car that measure the deceleration and acceleration, of course. And if those are quite high after a crash, a blue light will come on in the front. And this tells you that you must see the doctor at the circuit and they will have a good look at you and hopefully tell you that you're okay to keep racing. We do a lot for safety, and we are working towards always making cars and racing even more safe. I hope you enjoyed it and learned a little bit about it.